Hello everyone, myself Kaushik. Today I'm going to make a video on how to write proposal for Smart India Hackathon 2020. Before going into the main thing, like how to write a proposal, let me tell you why you have to participate in hackathons. So if you participate in hackathons, you'll know about yourself, right? Why? Because usually hackathons happen for 24 hours, 36 hours or 5 days. It depends on the organizer who is conducting the hackathon. So in that particular stipulated time, what you need to do is you need to take a problem, build a solution, build a prototype or build a software, and then that software or the prototype which you have developed have to be pitched to any investors or any judges who are coming to you, and if they get impressed, you'll be selected. So in this whole process, what's happening is in a particular time period, you are working on some problem and you are getting some solution to it. So this is what hackathon is. And as I already mentioned in my previous videos, the trend is changing in recruiting. If you participate in hackathons, if you develop something and if you put it on GitHubs, then only you are recruited. Otherwise, you are not recruited. The old traditional methods are gone, or it will be going in 2 to 3 years. So please keep this in mind and participate in more and more hackathons so that you can enhance your skills, or you can be participating in hackathons so that you will be participating with so many people around the country and around the world, so that you can enhance your skills and you can know better about what technologies are there in the market and on what technologies you will be working, and obviously you can enhance those skills on the go. Now coming to Smart India Hackathon, it is supported by MHRD and AICTE. It's been happening from past 3 or 4 years. Here the best thing is the problem statements are given by ministries, PSUs, NGOs and some private companies. So those are the problems which are currently there in the market. Okay, these are given by these people. Now the student team which forms will have to work on these problem statements given by ministries or PSUs or NGOs and private companies, and we have to build a solution for the country. So this is one good thing in Smart India Hackathon 2020. Already the problem statements are there on the Smart India Hackathon website. You can always go and view those problem statements. As I said, there are 350 plus problem statements are already available. They have divided into two categories. One is hardware and one is software. You can always go to website. You can just drop down the boxes for software or hardware, and you can select whichever is of your interest. Usually computer science and IT people go for software, and electrical, electronics, mechanical, civil, automobile people will go into hardware. It's not that only those people can do software or hardware. You can always combine, like two of your team can be from hardware, from electronics, electrical or mechanical or civil, and three or four people can be from computer science and one can be from IT. So this kind of combination can lead you to do to develop some software packages or hardwares. So this is what the intention of Smart India Hackathon is. This time Smart India Hackathon 2020, it's been announced that they are concentrating more to get 100 startups at least. This is what the statement given by Chief Innovation Officer of MHRD. What he's telling is this time they are going to at least get 100 startups from these ideas. So very good opportunity for young people like you, so that you can participate, you can develop models, and you can closely work with ministries or PSUs to get your startup dream. Next. Previously the hackathons were happening in the other way. This time they have changed the module. First, the college has to identify the SPOC. SPOC stands for single point of contact. I'm sorry. He can be dean, principal, HOD or any faculty from the college. First, they have to identify the SPOC. This time, SPOC has to conduct pre-hackathon in the college. Previously, it was not the case. Students have to submit their idea. After they submit, they should go to SPOC. SPOC will read into your proposal. If any changes are there, he'll inform you, and then he'll upload that. This time, it's not the case. SPOC has to conduct pre-hackathon. The internal hackathon has to happen in college. After happening internal hackathon, from that internal hackathon, the SPOC has to select 7 teams. 7 teams, you please make mark these words, 7 teams has to get selected from a college, out of which 5 should be software teams and 2 should be hardware teams. So, internal hackathon has to happen in the college. Out of that, 7 teams has to get selected. From that, 5 software and 2 hardware. Then, after selecting these 7 teams, now student is not submitting the ideas. It's SPOC again who has to submit all the details regarding the selected teams, like his name, his team name, his team teammates' names, his mail IDs. So his idea, his proposal, everything has to be submitted by SPOC so that no disturbances will happen. So this is what the new change in this here hackathon. And after SPOC conducts pre-hackathon, he has to submit details of the hackathon, like on what date you have conducted the hackathon in your college, the photographs, if you have invited judges, the details of those judges, and what is the criteria you have followed to select these 7 teams. So these kind of things have to be submitted to the SIH portal. This is again SPOC's duty. And this time, the idea submission date is Jan 25th. They are not going to extend this time. Previously, they extended the dates, but this time, as every college has to submit only 7 teams, it is easy, and Jan 25th is the 25th is the hard deadline. So I hope you understood the procedure this time, what they are following. And then coming to proposal, it is mentioned again by the Chief Innovative Officer of MHRD. What they are telling is the proposals which are submitted, most of the proposals are copy-paste from the internet. They are not at all to the standards what they are expecting. Okay, so this time SPOC has to concentrate more on making students to write proposal well. So this is the common like structure what it is given by SIH people only. It has been explained already, but I'll explain once more. So it should consist of 3 slides. It should consist of 3 slides. If you want, you can just increase 1 or 2. Otherwise, it is not advisable. You have to fit your proposal in 3 slides only. The first slide should consist of the ministry or organization name. So you would have selected one problem statement. It is given by any ministry or private company or PSU or NGO. Which company or which ministry has given, that name has to be indicated here. And then problem statement. What is the problem statement name? And then team name. So you obviously your team will have some name. See that it should not be there should not be any college name in the team name. Okay, so team name should be given here, and then team leader name, and then college code. Your AICT code or AIH code will be there, that you have to write here. The first slide goes like this. Next, the second slide, it should have describe your idea or solution or prototype. So if you go on website for looking for the problem statements, already people have given abstract of what that problem is. So don't copy that again. You read that problem, you do some survey, what are the existing methods already available for that particular problem statement, and what are the pain points in it, what are the disadvantages of it, and what kind of improvements you want to make to the existing model. So this is what they are looking for. If you are describing your idea, you just tell the problem statement, existing methodology, what are the disadvantages in it, and then how you are going to address that with technology. This is what is expected in describe your idea, solution or prototype. And then describe your technology stack. In order to address that problem, what are the technologies you are using, like artificial intelligence or machine learning, or otherwise technology stack, software technology stacks can be like Python or anything, Arduino. If you are going for hardware, Arduino, Raspberry Pi, MATLAB, if you are using, you name the toolboxes and the softwares. So this is the technology stack which you are using to address the problem. This has to be mentioned here. Okay, so what their suggestion is to use open source softwares. This is the suggestion made by them. Why? Because it will be easy for you if you start your own startup, if you are going for patents. So this is what about describe your technology stack. And then the third slide. The third slide has describe your use cases. Describe your use cases means if you take SIH platform only, if you go to SIH website, there are three or four use cases like register as Spark, register as student, register as mentor, register as evaluator, for admin one panel is these, like this is one software called SIH software platform, and these are the use cases like administrator, register as Spark, register as mentor, register as something else. These are the use cases of your product which you have developed. If you go to hardware, let's suppose you have developed a system to just detect the forest fires. So if you have developed that system, what is the use cases? Forest Ministry of Forest can use that prototype. Otherwise, if any local communities are there, if they want to know about it, they also can use that hardware package. So I'm sorry for the disturbance. So this will be one use case. Okay. So if some five department wants to use, they also can use the prototype which you have developed. So basically, if you develop a software product or hardware product, who are the users which are using your software or hardware, that should be mentioned in this. And then describe your dependencies or showstopper, which means let's suppose you are developing a traffic management system, okay, and you currently don't have the data about the traffic. Why? Because CCTV camera footage has to be available to you. If it is given, like most of the problem statement, I have read all the problem statements, ISRO people, they are giving all the data sets like satellite imagery, they are giving CCTV imagery based on the problem statement, they have given the data sets. And most of the companies, if anything is required for you, like if you are working on artificial intelligence or machine learning, if the data is required for you, like speech, audio or any images or any video sets, or everything is available online. Okay, it is in the problem statements only. If something is not available and if it is stopping you to develop your model, that should be mentioned here. Okay, I hope you understood what is like dependencies or showstopper. If you want to develop something and if that requires some bigger hardware or something else and you don't have that and that is stopping you, you should mention here. So this is what it has to be there in your slides. And coming to team, six members should be there in your team and one female candidate should be there. Five male, it is compulsory that one female candidate should be there in your team. Okay, so I think I have briefed everything. So Jan 25th, remember this date, they are not going to extend, and internal hackathon has to happen, and it is Spark's responsibility to upload the details of the students. If you have any doubts, you can always comment in the comment section. I can always answer you people. It is better to go to SIH portal, go for FAQs, frequently asked questions are there. You can refer there. There is a grievance section in the SIH portal. You can always ask them. Still, you have any doubts in writing the proposal, if you have any doubts, you can always comment. I can help you. Thank you very much.